अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल। स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस वीडियो कंटेंट आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द एंटीबायोटिक रेजिस्टेंस, वन ऑफ द इम्पोर्टेंट टॉपिक एसोसिएटेड विद द थेरापेटिक यूजेस ऑफ द ड्रग्स। इन दिस वीडियो आई विल टेल यू द मैकेनिजम्स ऑफ द एंटीबायोटिक रेजिस्टेंस एंड द वेज बाय विच द एंटीबायोटिक रेजिस्टेंस एक्वायर इन द बैक्टीरिया, हाउ द बैक्टीरिया बिल्ट रेजिस्टेंस or how the bacteria acquire resistance, the answer of this question is being described in this video. So let's start. Antibiotic resistance. Antibiotic resistance occurs when an antibiotic loses its ability to effectively control or kill the bacteria. In this case, the bacteria become resistant and continue to grow because the antibiotic being administered has no ability to kill them. How the bacteria built resistance? Antibiotic resistance is a complicated issue. You may be aware that it is one of the greatest threats of the public health. Here I have created a series of the graphics that illustrate the relation between the antibiotic and their resistance by the bacterial cell. The mechanism of the antibiotic resistance. There are a number of mechanisms that the bacterial cell use to prevent the effect of the antibiotic. At number first is the some bacteria are naturally resistant due to the unusual impermeable cell membrane, or they may be the lack of the target that the antibiotics attack on the bacterial cell. Other bacteria are capable of producing the enzymes that can inactivate the antibiotics upon contact. So these are the enzymes produced by the bacterial cell, and when the antibiotic attack the bacterial cell, these enzymes inactivate these antibiotics. So there is no effect of the antibiotic on the bacterial cell. In some other cases, the bacteria can modify the antibiotic's target, rendering the antibiotic ineffective. In this case, the bacterial cell changes the receptors or the target of the antibiotic drug, so there is no combination of the antibiotic on the antibiotic target in the bacterial cell. Another important mechanism or the procedure for the bacterial cells to get resistance is the efflux pumping. Bacteria can also produce efflux pumps which can transport antibiotics out of the bacterial cell before they can take effect. So whenever the antibiotics is get out from the bacterial cell, there is no effect of the antibiotic on the bacterial cell. Now moving toward the ways that the bacteria acquire resistance. There are two main ways that the bacterial cell can acquire resistance is the one is through mutations that occur in the DNA of the cell during replication. Specific genetic mutations are the molecular basis of the resistance to this specific drugs. For example, in streptomycin, there is ribosomal mutation. Quinolones, there is DNA gyrase gene mutation. And one of the important drug is the rifampin. There is RNA polymerase gene mutation. The mutation to rifampin is an example of the single step mutation. In this case, Escherichia coli, Staphylococcus aureus exposure to rifampin results in the highly resistant strain due to a point mutation in RNA polymerase gene, such that polymerase protein no longer binds the rifampin. So there is no action of the rifampin on the bacterial cell. There is the mechanism of the bacterial resistance against due to the mutation is that this is the bacterial colony and these bacteria are the susceptible, and this one is the bacteria that is mutant against the antibacterial drug. So this resistant bacteria, when we apply the antibiotic on this bacterial colony, and this antibiotic have no effect against this resistant bacteria, and due to which mutations, the mutation causes the inactivation of the antibiotic on this bacteria, and there is proliferation of the resistance bacteria in the bacterial colony. So the antibiotic have no effect on the bacterial cell, and this is the resistance against the antibacterial drug. Then moving toward the other way, that is the other way that the bacteria acquire resistance is through the horizontal gene transfer. There are three different ways in which this can occur, but in each case genetic material is transferred from the antibiotic resistant bacteria to the other bacterial cell, making them resistant to antibiotic as well. More usually acquired by the horizontal transfer of the resistance factors from a donor cell, perhaps of a different species, by the transformation which involves the incorporation of the DNA found free environment into the bacterial genome. For example, once the bacterial cell acquires resistance, exposure to antibiotics kills off non-resistance bacteria, while the antibiotic resistance bacteria continue to proliferate out. One of the example is the penicillin resistance. An example of this process is the basis of the penicillin resistance in pneumococci. Penicillin resistance pneumococci produce different penicillin binding proteins. These different penicillin binding protein exhibit relatively low affinity for the penicillin compared to the wild type pneumococci. So this is the example of the horizontal gene transfer. So this is the ways by which the bacterial cell resistance can be transferred from one bacterial cell to the other. So this is all about the antibiotic resistance. Thank you very much.